違いな。
Put a finger down if you've ever suppressed thousands of people's liberties. Hi, I'm Fidel Castro, and my life is pretty crazy.
Fidel Castro, born in 1926, was a Cuban communist revolutionary and perhaps one of the strongest leaders in Cuban history.
After leading rebellions against the Dominican Republic and Colombia, he tried his luck against the Cuban government, but ended up in prison.
After being released, Castro wanted to challenge the dictatorship of Fulgencio Batista. So he led the Cuban Revolution and successfully overthrew Batista in 1959.
In his first year as prime minister, he led executions for much of his opposition, claiming that he was giving them the punishment they deserved.
But this was only the beginning of an era of censorship and suppression.
This is Fidel Castro, the movie.
Fidel, ¿por qué lo hiciste?
No me gusta Batista. Las ideas de Karl Marx me enseñaron cómo debería ser la sociedad. Entonces dije, amigos, este movimiento triunfará.
Fidel! Fidel!
No es tu burrito, es nuestro burrito.
Communism!
Fidel! Fidel, what are you looking at?
Cuba.
Castro took great measures to improve infrastructure, healthcare, and literacy, so the people trusted that he was looking out for them.
We're very opposed to the authoritarian nature of Cuba, but you know, it's unfair to simply say everything is bad. You know, when Fidel Castro came into office, you know what he did? He had a massive literacy program. Is that a bad thing? Even though Fidel Castro did it?
There's a lot of dissidents imprisoned in Cuba.
That's right, and we condemn that. Unlike Donald Trump, let's be clear, I do not think that Kim Jong-un is a good friend. I don't trade love letters with a murdering dictator. Vladimir Putin, not a great friend of mine.
But very quickly, the economy crashed, and fear of the US resisting Cuban communism led to Castro to announce a new model of government. The Soviet model.
From the very beginning, the USA disapproved and did not want Castro to become prime minister. This was all happening during the Cold War, so everyone was kind of on edge about the presence of communism.
President Kennedy declared a trade embargo on Cuba, and the CIA received a lot of funding to fight Cuba.
Castro feared a US-led coup in his country, but he was beginning to find success in getting some Americans on his side.
Still, he wanted to be safe and make sure that he would rule for as long as possible. And nobody was acting against the government, even if that meant suppressing all liberties.
He let much of his staff go, fearing they were US spies, and he ordered his police force to arrest suspected counter-revolutionaries.
¿Piensa que era necesario acallar estos ciudadanos?
Absolutamente. Necesitaba saber que nadie podía ir en contra de mí. Quería unir Cuba.
Although the Cuban Constitution outlines freedoms of speech and press, Fidel required that the speech and press is in line with the aims of the socialist state.
Those who expressed any opinions against the government through speech or press were silenced and faced incarceration in horrible prisons, harassment, and intimidation tactics by the government.
Castro's help started to decline, so he didn't need to be punished by the law. He was already being punished by his own body.
After Fidel Castro retired, his brother Raul took his spot, and the Castro leadership era only ended in 2018 with the start of Miguel Díaz-Canel's rule.
Unfortunately, Cuba has not changed much since Castro left office. Even today, there is little freedom of press, and media is heavily censored due to Cuba's communist government. Citizens need permits to use the internet, and only recently were mobile phones allowed.
Many of the tactics developed during Castro's rule, including surveillance, beatings, arbitrary detention, and public acts of repudiation, are unfortunately still commonly used by the government.
We are working to repair relations with Cuba. The borders are now open to Americans.